Hi students and welcome back to BankExamsToday.com. And today we are going to do the day 5th of our 5 minutes vocabulary. It means again we are going to learn 5 new words, their usage, their antonyms and synonyms, right? So without wasting any minute, because this is just a 5 minutes video and I don't want to take much of your time, so we start with the very first word, which is consensus. Consensus, it means the general agreement of people. I remember when I was in college, there was a guy who stood up in the class and asked, who wants to go for the mask bunk? And everybody said, just raise their hands, and they are all agreed to going for the mask bunk. So that is a general agreement of people who matters in an organization or in a community. So the consensus is agreement. Harmony, because people agreed to a set of regulations. Concord, concurrence and consent. So basically it is consent of people in an organization, society or community. The antonyms are denial. You do deny the fact or you deny the proposal. Disagreement, you don't agree to it. Dissension, opposition and refusal. The example is, the teacher asked the group to reach a consensus on who would present their data to the class. So consensus, it means the group has to decide who is going to represent the data to the class. Okay, so this is consensus, the general agreement on a particular topic, on a presentation or any issue. Second word is profligate. Profligate is basically an adjective we use for the person who does not spend money wisely. If he has money, he is going to spend it in a reckless manner. Like, I don't care if I have the money or not. He is going to spend it recklessly without any consideration that if one day he does not have it, what he is going to do. He is being profligate. That is the characteristic of his personality. Spending money. Sometimes we use the word profligate when we are referring to people who use their resources unwisely. Like, we do not care about the running water or polluting the air. We are profligate in that manner because we do not care about the environment or the resources we have right now. Okay, so profligate is wasteful, the person who wastes the money or resources, prodigal, immoderate and excessive. Then the antonyms are gentle, saving and thrifty, right? And the examples are, Tim made a lot of profligate purchases after winning the lottery. Profligate, it means he spent the money unwisely before thinking about anything. Then the next word is stentorian. Stentorian means a very loud noise. Basically, if someone has a habit of speaking with a very loud noise, like he or she is just shouting, that is stentorian. The voice which is loud and powerful. Sometimes when the voice is on the speakers, on the DJ, that kind of voice is also stentorian. Very loud and very powerful. Sometimes you have to close your ears to save it from like bleeding. Okay, it gives you headache when the music is playing really loud or the music is stentorian. The synonyms are loud, booming, thundering, thunderous, deafening. Deafening, that makes you deaf. Antonyms are very quiet, silent, still and peaceful. It means there is no noise, serene. Example is, during boot camp, we were often awakened by the stentorian voice of our drill sergeant. Stentorian voice which is loud and powerful. The next word is perverse. So perverse is something that is generally really awkward. For example, you are asked to be in formal dress for your office party or any office meeting. That is a very formal function. But one person shows up in a very shiny and vibrant colored clothes. like orange or something glittery, that is going to be unexpected because this is supposed to be a formal meeting. So that is perverse. Perverse because that person is contrary to what is accepted. What was the accepted code? To be in formal clothes or formal attires, but he showed up in a very glittery clothes. So that is not accepted or beyond your standard practices. Okay, so perverse is awkward. First word you get for it is awkward. Awkward, someone that is not socially accepted. Contrary, difficult. Unreasonable, because reasonable is that we accept, and unreasonable that we do not accept. Uncooperative. Cooperative is being following the rules, but you are not following the rules, you are just going against it. Antonyms are agreeable, compliant, nice and reasonable. Then this example, Jim has perverse way of staring at me that makes me feel really nervous. Perverse way of staring, it means he has a very awkward manner of staring that the other person starts feeling nervous. Like if I am going to stare you like this. This is awkward. Why would someone stare at you like this? You will feel nervous and you will say that person is really awkward. How is he staring at me? Right? So that is perverse, being perverse. The last word for today is rancor. Rancor is basically hatred among people. The bitterness, not liking each other. That is rancor. You see that debates on the TV from all the representatives from different parties, political parties showed up or show up in the debate. For in the beginning, they are like modest, they are gentle, they are talking very politely. But as the debates gets heated, their hatred, their rancor comes out. They start shouting at each other, they start blaming each other. So that kind of atmosphere is full of rancor, full of that all the bitterness, resentfulness, especially when long standing. Okay, so you don't like someone, that is rancor. So synonyms are bitterness, spite, hate, hatred, resentment, ill will, malevolence, anything you can say, but rancor is the general feeling of hatred towards someone. Antonyms are friendliness, you accept a person as a friend, friendship, goodwill, kindness and sympathy. Right? And the example is, the fiery debate created rancor among the political candidates. It means the debate got fiery and it created rancor. It created bitterness among the candidates. Okay? So this is all about today's video. You can download the PDF from the description section. Okay, and if you have any query, just drop an email raman@bankexamstoday.com. This is all about today's video. I'll see you in the next video. Till then, keep practicing, work hard.